What's going on, my fellow residents? It's me, the Frozen Cavern, and today we might be ending off Minecraft Story Mode. You guys would already know where we are, but today we might be ending it off. Now, last episode, we got caught up in some games, and pretty much everyone else who was with us got eliminated, and we're the only ones left. And now we're going to start off with investigating inside of how the old builders live. I don't exactly know the name.
A man forever voyaging by... Soren, another one? Where do these keep coming from?
So either they're taking stuff from the other worlds, or which would make sense, or Soren somehow gets his books like internationally. That I'm pretty sure they don't see you.
I've never seen a quartz desk before.
Okay, so we might just need to tap on that glass because there's not really... Wow. Like, that's the only thing we can actually touch.
Impressive.
And then there's the armor there. The armor of Tim. I'm not touching that armor.
That's Tim guy's armor.
Welcome, Jesse.
Fantastic. Okay, you appeared out of nowhere.
Just fantastic. Thanks for accepting my invitation. Well, it seems appropriate that you'd gravitate toward Tim's armor. What with everyone calling you the new Tim down there? Yes, I've heard the rumors that they're calling you that, and I can definitely see why. People love an underdog story.
Give it to me straight. Why did you invite me up here, Hadrian?
Why, so we could continue to discuss the terms of our deal.
More terms?
You can look closer. Go ahead. I assume by now you've heard all about Tim.
Repeatedly.
Everyone loves him. And why shouldn't they? After all, he's Tim.
Doesn't that bug you? Aren't these supposed to be your games?
And they are still my games. I love having a legend that can inspire my competitors. Tim is an inspiration to them, even when he's not here. One could say he's an inspiration because he's not here.
What do you mean?
It's so much easier for a legend to stay nice and shiny when it's a fond memory. Easier to control it. I've been watching your legend grow, but I worry that with you still in the picture, it could get... messy. I've been starting to think it would be best if you made a quiet exit. You don't belong here. These games aren't for you.
Well, that doesn't sound like the deal we made. You trying to change our terms?
Think of this as a shiny new deal.
See, there's which
something
would be...
you should know about the games. No one ever wins unless we want them to. Not even Tim. Let that sink in for a moment, eh?
I'm not buying it, Hadrian. Is Tim even real?
I knew you were a smart one, bucko. Of course he's not real.
Okay, I was assuming that because he was
playing the games, but
I had it in the back of my head.
Which is why I think it'd be in your best interest to play along. But don't you miss your friends? Your treehouse?
Wait, my treehouse?
How would he know about that?
Where people are from, you know. So I had Mevia go check it out. Turns out you're pretty famous. I was impressed. I had to bring back some things you might be interested in.
Axel! Olivia!
Hey, Jesse!
Oh my gosh, I can't believe you're here.
Yeah.
So have they been here this whole time?
Showed up and knocked us out. Now we're in
well, no, they would have to have showed up in episode 8.
And that guy's voice is the worst. I can even hear it through the obsidian.
Not gonna lie, guys, it's bad. We're in a world where everyone is forced to compete in these crazy games and will be prisoners forever if I don't win.
That is bad.
I'm so sorry you guys got roped into this.
Yeah, that's not the best.
Wait until I tell the others you're here. I've missed you guys so much.
Wow, this is just, wow. Such a tapestry of human trauma and emotion. And we haven't even gotten to the best part.
If you bring back Reuben.
What?
Oh, yes.
He brought back Reuben.
Reuben.
If he's a zombie.
sup.
I've heard all about him. Your best friend. Your partner in crime.
Hadrian, for an old builder, you are not that bright, you know that?
What? I told you, bro, but my name is Reuben, but the Reuben you're thinking of, he was like a little piggy. Though seriously, dude, big fan.
So you used the Atlas to kidnap my friends and that other guy. Why?
Yeah, incentive, Jesse, incentive. See, even if you win, and that's a mighty big if, they will be staying to work in the mines forever. Or until they get a shot at competing, which is still basically forever.
No!
Okay, so what's your deal?
If you lose the next match and go work in my mines, then I'll let your friends go. All of them. You'll just have to stay behind in their place. I hear it's terrible in those mines. But aren't your friends worth it?
You're messing with the wrong guy.
And his friends.
Yeah, they're awesome!
Just being supportive?
I'm not messing with anyone. I'm just trying to maintain my games here. Okay, I had hoped that watching your sad reunion would be entertaining, but I'm done now. What do you say, sport? Your freedom for theirs, huh?
Do you think you're worth
it? Of course.
Than all of them? Do you even really think you could win these games?
Wow, tough one. That's actually kind of a good deal.
Yeah. Except the part where Jesse would be stuck here forever.
Oh, yeah. No, I take that back.
I wouldn't stay here forever. My friends would try and break me up.
Jesse,
I know it.
Hey, there we go, sport fans. Well, I tell you, I'm pretty
excited. Plus, I could easily just lie to him.
I think we're all winners here. But just to be sure you don't try and renege on me, we'll keep your friends nice and safe in here. Remember, they're counting on you. Slab! Be a pal and give our new friend a walk home.
Sure thing. Come on, squishy.
Man, I want to actually kill this guy. This guy is actually going to die by the end of this episode. If he does not, he will be like the one bad character I've let live. He's not living. He is not going to live.
Up there.
Hadrian has Axel and Olivia.
What?
He used the Atlas to snatch them from our world.
No.
Are they okay?
Other than Hadrian having them trapped in obsidian prisons. But he offered me a deal. He said he'll send you all home if I lose and go to the mines in your place.
You didn't take it, right?
Oh, dear.
No! Why would you do that?
Oh my, oh my, oh my.
I'd have never let you do this.
Petra, come on. I'm sure Jesse feels bad enough as it is.
I did it to save you guys. That's what this has all been about.
But you'll be trapped. Probably forever.
And he'll have the redstone heart.
Yeah, but at least I know you guys will be free.
That's ridiculous. There's no way Hadrian will actually send your friends home.
He'll wait till you lose and then send you all to the mines anyway. Probably. While claiming that was the original deal.
So, who's supposed to help us then? Hadrian and Mevia are both clearly the worst.
But what about the third guy?
Otto? How could he help? He's always stayed out of the more lever-pulling sides of the games.
He seems like a big fan of the rules. Maybe we can use that to our advantage.
He loves rules, that's for sure. Always plays by them. If you won, I know he would definitely make sure you got that Atlas. That was the original deal, and he's an honorable man.
Harper, Hadrian still has my friends trapped in that obsidian prison. I can win the Atlas, but I'm gonna need you to get them out.
I can handle it.
Good. There's three of them. They're in Hadrian's office.
Wait, wait, wait. You really think you can free everyone in this place and win the games?
Yeah.
Good luck with that last part. Do you really think you could just beat all the other teams by yourself?
That is a pretty tall order. Even for you, Jesse.
Oh, it's impossible is what it is.
The old builders expect us all to fight each other. I don't intend to give them the satisfaction.
You're what? Gonna convince everyone to work together?
Oh, yeah.
Whoa. Looks like we've got a little bit of an audience here.
Please don't be expecting us to fight right now.
cue to do your thing.
Let's hope this goes better than the mansion.
Tomorrow we have to stand up to the old builders together.
Actually, I think you mean the gladiators. They're the ones that keep kicking our butts in the games.
Actually, the gladiators work for the old builders, and they never want us to be able to win. Hadrian keeps twisting and changing the rules. I say it's our time to change the rules on them.
What's the point? Hadrian will still have all the power. There's no way he's gonna let us just take that from him. He'll just make up some new rule. It's useless.
Don't you want to go home, Em?
I do, more than anything. But nobody beats Hadrian at his own games. Nobody.
Hey, Tim did!
Great.
The only thing keeping me going in here.
Oh, yeah. Because if it were not for Tim, I probably would have given up a long time ago.
Here is a major, major thing. Like, I could lie to them, but if they found out that I lied about that, they're going to turn on me. That's the thing. They're going to just take all that back. I gotta tell him.
Actually, Tim's not real.
That's... No way. Of course Tim's real. Look at the banners.
Are you sure?
Yeah, Hadrian told me.
I knew it. All of that stuff about him seems so implausible.
So wait, Tim's made up. They just invented him.
What a highly elaborate fabrication.
Of course he is. It's all a part of how the old builders keep their control over everyone.
That's awful.
Seriously.
But we can beat them.
The old builders already controlled everything else. Of course they control the games. Why should I even try anymore? Sitting in their stupid tower, pulling all the levers.
What, like you're just going to quit?
Yeah. Quitting is like for a quitters, dude. I'll be sure to remember that. The next time I've got a gladiator aiming for my head with an enchanted sword.
Yeah, I mean, like, your plan to take down the old builders sounds cool and all, but, those gladiators are, like, super tough.
Like, max level scariness, okay? Boo! Oh, no, I mean, totally OP.
It's true. Any one of those gladiators could probably beat any of us to a pulp one-on-one.
Where's Jesse going with this?
There's no way they'd be able to do that if we all tried to fight them at once.
Oh, I get it.
If we work together...
You didn't have to say that out loud.
Okay, now just bring it home, Jesse.
You can do it.
Doing awesome.
You might not believe in yourselves, but I believe in you. And I believe that we will be free.
Yeah! Not real? I can't believe it.
Look, it was a nice speech, but strength doesn't come from speeches. Actions speak louder than words. Can't expect you to just talk your way through this, Jesse.
Strength comes from believing in yourself, Em.
Sounds like a bunch of nonsense, Jesse.
Yeah, that was extremely cheesy, but didn't have much time for that one.
Some crowd. Think they got through to him?
Wait, so who are we fighting then?
Oh my goodness.
Reaction definitely.
Same as Jesse.
Mixed.
Yeah, no kidding.
Lot of diehard Tim fans.
Yeah, totally. I mean, you did hear it, right?
Loud and clear. It just might not have been enough.
Well, I guess we'll find out for sure in the morning.
Let's just hope. Let us hope. I mean, it was gonna come down to Tim actually being a real person. Tim might actually probably be a person.
Competitors ready for the final challenge? The
walls!
So, scared? Because it's okay if you are. No one will judge you for it.
Can I be honest with you? I am a little scared. I'm worried.
Scared.
Oh, I guess that's what I get for being honest.
Bevia, for those unfamiliar with the walls,
You know, I was about to say that me and Jesse are extremely relatable, but considering we're the same person. Oh, right, this game. Gather materials, build defenses, and craft in their section
before the walls come down. Wait, I only see dirt and gravel in my section.
Of course.
I'm sorry. Is that going to be a problem?
The sections are drawn at random.
Oh, you work for the worst people. Did you know that?
Yeah, but that dental plan, though. See?
Once the walls are down, it's every team for themselves.
But is surviving the walls the end, Mevia?
No, it is not, Hadrian. Whichever team survives the free-for-all needs to step onto the winner's platform in the center of the arena.
Winner, but why, though?
But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Because that's only if the would-be winners can defeat...
Gladiators! That's right! So all competitors better get to gathering materials, because that clock is ticking!
Dog.
Oh, this is great. It's not all dirt and gravel. Maybe we have to dig down somewhere.
That our newcomer Jesse's section has a
okay, dirt. Dig that up.
Dirt and gravel.
Nope, just dirt.
Like it's all part of a plan. Or
there has to be something else around here.
Hilarious.
Gravel? Gravel, that's worse than dirt.
So we have essentially nothing.
At least they gave me a crafting table. Now if only I actually had anything to craft with.
I mean, we... No, making our own walls won't work because they could just break them down. So yay, we have literally nothing. Yeah, we have quite literally nothing.
Hey.
Seems like they're happy you didn't get anything. I think they're making fun of you. But just my, you know, professional opinion. There's a gladiator. Who's heard this a lot?
Oh, you think?
Well, yeah, I do actually.
Rhetorical question.
Yay.
Oh, do you know what time it is? Ask me what time
I thought
it
by
is
that camera angle, someone was sneaking up behind him.
It's time for the walls to come down.
Okay, it usually takes way longer for the walls to come down, but whatever. I have a feeling she's faking it.
Jesse.
This could get ugly.
Let's hope.
Okay, do whatever it is you have to do.
Whatever you say.
Jesse isn't even trying to defend
I'm hoping
her.
That this is... I'm hoping she's faking this. She probably is.
Here
hopefully.
Comes.
The finishing blow!
Figured I'd try believing in myself for once and take a chance.
It appears Emily has opted to not.
Thank you. You made the right decision.
Well, you could say you really inspired me.
Oh, well, that's...
Could, but don't.
This isn't how it was supposed to be.
Oh, so what's we're still
on?
Finding you?
I have no idea.
Come on. Over here.
Yeah. Why aren't you all killing each other?
Tja, man, I can totally see why you'd be confused.
Yeah, we're, confused. I mean, usually the little teams all kill each other, you know?
Aren't you tired of letting the old builders use you like this?
Like awesome people?
No, like little pieces in their games, doing whatever they say.
Don't you see? None of us are the enemy. It's them.
They're the enemies. They're behind everything.
Oh, my head hurts.
Too many perspectives.
Oh, my goodness.
It appears that Jesse has decided that deals don't need to be kept and is trying to convince the gladiators to follow suit.
These aren't your games anymore, Hadrian.
These weren't our games? Wow, my urge to destroy is dissipating.
Go, imbeciles!
Lab? Lab! What should we do?
I'm sure that the slaughter will commence soon, right?
With Slab leading the charge, it should be no problem at all.
You should be on our side. Join us.
I don't know.
Facemate finds that idea weird.
Not going with them, Slab?
I mean, not being on anyone's side is better than not being on our on the opposite side, so...
...bosses who use people or manipulate them. That's inconsiderate. But you, when I was mean to you, pushed you around and made you go to the tower with me, you got that I was just doing my job and came anyway so we could be on time. That was real considerate. I will join you, Tiny Jesse.
I think it's time.
Alright, I'm pretty sure it was only that last part that determined whether he was actually gonna stay here. So glad I did that.
As stated in our rules, anyone who is not eliminated may step on the victory platform and win the game.
And there's the stickler of the rules.
Right behind you, fearless leader.
8-2 slap. You'll pay for that.
This wasn't the deal, Jesse. No, no!
I don't care.
And they've done it. The competitors have all stepped onto the platform together, which, by the Builder Game bylaws, means they are all the winners.
Which I'm sure my colleague means to say, we are going to find some way to disqualify them.
No, we are not. They all win.
No!
Levia, Otto, with me. We're ending this. We had a deal, and you broke it, bucko! We had an agreement! You promised me!
And to think we let you compete!
You should be ashamed of yourselves, manipulating all these people like this!
How dare you?
This isn't up to you! We control the games! We decide their outcome!
Mevia...
Shut up, Otto! This runt needs to pay for ruining our fun!
Seems like you're losing your temper there, Mevia. What's the matter? Not having fun anymore?
Why, you little!
Now, Mevia, Jesse won these games fair and square. He's earned the Atlas.
Otto, I would think very carefully about what you're doing.
I have. Jesse, with the power vested in me as an officiator of the
Builder
Games... That's
an interesting looking book. Not surprising at all.
About time we end this.
Whoa, this. All right, pretty sure it's final boss time. And I can't wait to kill Baldi.
Now, because I will trap you here forever.
If you want it, come and get it.
Your wish is my command, Buckaroo.
This is useless.
Well.
Just when you thought M had your...
M, come back!
Now that you've lost your oversized friend, you really don't stand a chance.
Run away, little Emily.
I'm still with you, Jesse.
Thank you.
You're gonna need all the help you can get, Jesse. Time to take what is mine. I'll admit you're quick sport.
Okay, magical changing weapon.
No, what the?
Don't forget my axe, Hadrian.
No,
Slab.
It was an honor to fight the giant.
Slab.
Great.
Gotta admit, kid, you've shown you got skills. But you're still no match.
See about that.
I got this, Hadrian.
Had enough, Hadrian?
Wait. You're right.
Boy, I'm not falling for that. Kill this man now.
Game.
You expect me to believe that?
Come on, sport. Haven't you ever had anything get away from you before? I mean, can't you forgive me?
Of course.
Game?
Hearts fans!
The Redstone Heart has been returned to its proper owners!
I lost.
Hey, fancy meeting you here. You know, I've sent hundreds of competitors to these respawn pits. Never knew it hurt so much. Sorry. That's probably not helping your mood right now.
It's over.
Oh, I don't think so.
It's us! Yeah!
I'm so happy to see you guys.
You said you believed in me, Jesse. Figured I'd return the favor and believe in everyone else. You know, because I'm awesome. And we both need to get out of this.
As someone once told me, teamwork makes the dream work.
So let's get to work.
Let's take
it. That would be Captain Sparkles.
I lost my inventory when I respawned. How am I supposed to get the Atlas back without any weapons or armor or anything?
Well, we may have made a little stop in Hadrian's inventory room and helped ourselves to a few things.
Awesome.
Here, buddy.
Wow.
Take this.
Thanks.
Hey, suspenders. Over here.
Tim's armor.
And Tim, quote unquote, armor.
Time to kick some old builder butt. Now to pick a weapon to go with my sweet new armor.
Not gonna be able to kill with a shield. I mean, sword is easily like the best attack wise, but I don't know. This is actually a really difficult choice. I can't decide what to do to them. I'm hoping that I can do dual wielding as well, because if not, that's gonna kind of upset me. Let's go with axe.
Ooh, nice.
Sweet.
Even though I could kind of use all of them by just switching, so.
All those other competitors who betrayed us.
Well, Mevia, spending eternity in the quartz mines doesn't seem like punishment enough. I have something special in mind for them.
Hadrian, Mevia, this game just went into overtime.
Well, isn't that cute? You found Tim's armor.
Oh, well, isn't that just the sweetest thing, Hadrian?
You don't know my friends, Hadrian.
Those friends of yours will just hold you back in the end, slugger. Oh, I'm going to enjoy crushing you.
Same here. Yeah, like, I could switch weapons. What's the point of me choosing? Okay, that wasn't even there. Wait, I did not have those. I had dirt. Wait, no, I died though. I have a diamond pickaxe. Just
Harper,
yeah.
I'm gonna owe you one. Time to go to work.
Exactly, just dig out of it.
No, no, it can't be.
Did you guys not know how pickaxes work?
Wow, her inventory was huge.
Mavia, come on! What kind of rookie move was that? Now, bucko.
Hey, Hadrian!
Huh?
Over here!
You mess with one member of the Order of the Stone.
Where did all of you come from?
Jesse! I believe
in
you!
Time to shut you up!
You think this is going to help? You're deluded!
Let's take him to the slab lab. I'm still workshopping that one. Shut up. Let's go.
He's at least trying to help us.
Never could have won on your own.
Wish you had friends like mine yet?
Shut up! Just shut up! Alia, shut up!
I see you don't like having a live audience, Hadrian.
Come on!
Jesse, remember Spleet!
Got it.
Please don't save yourself somehow. Good.
I knew it! You and your stupid deals!
There's no time for that now, Mevia. We have to get out of here. Come on! Whoa! Hey! Guys!
How's it going?
It's going not the best. And you're not going anywhere.
Yeah. Face Meat wants to discuss his benefits plan.
Oh, hang on! What?
Jesse, you did it! Again! Feels like I say that a lot.
I couldn't have done anything without all of you.
Well done, Jesse. An excellent job.
Thanks, Otto.
You have truly shown my friends and I the error of our ways. I'm glad
it wasn't even really you.
Messy business behind us. Start over.
Man, do you need some new friends, you know that?
Yes, I've come to that same conclusion, and I am working on it. I also know that the Atlas is not mine to keep. You have fairly...
Yeah, I don't care. They can get beaten.
Seems only fair that you get to decide their fate, and with the Atlas, you can send them anywhere you want.
You know, there was this game that Olivia and I used to play back in our treehouse.
Huh?
Remember? We called it, Which Would You Rather Fight? And that's when I yanked Palma's redstone heart right out. And the whole thing shut down.
Oh, yeah. Axel and Olivia, don't know.
Crazy adventures. So many people trying to kill you.
Goodbye, Jesse.
So I'm assuming Otto knows which world everyone came from.
Anyhow, except you folks, that is. I can't believe how many competitors actually want to stay and keep playing the games. Thanks to you, my intrepid new friend, I can actually work on making them fun again. Very exciting. It'll be more challenging just by myself, but a good challenge.
You promise they'll stay fun this time, right?
Oh, yes. I don't intend to let the games get corrupted like they did before.
And I'm gonna help, too. You taught me a lot about fairness, Jesse. And I'd like to use that new knowledge for something good. Oh, and speaking of fairness, I think this is yours.
Oh, man.
There was some good stuff in there. I was really moved.
Awesome.
Guess he wasn't so immovable after all.
He could easily still, you know,
well,
punch you to pieces, so.
Said you wanted to go home, right?
Yes, I just can't decide if it's what I want. You get to leave and go on more adventures. Do I really want to go back to farming? I mean, it has been ages since I've seen it, and I miss my friends. But one of them bored.
Well, if you want, you can come with us.
Oh, really? Like, really?
Yeah, we could always use another awesome person, and... Well, you're pretty awesome.
Ah! Jesse! That's wonderful! Thank you so much!
And so now we have another partner. Problem is, last episode, won't be able to use her.
Hello!
What you doing?
I was just observing Harper, all by herself, over there. She seems lonely.
Come on. Hey, Harper.
Oh, hey, Jesse, Ivor. I was just watching folks head on home.
There's like no one else here.
It worked out, huh? Well, I guess this is goodbye. I'm going to head on back to Crown Mesa and see how the post-Palma construction is going. Just hope they'll take me back. It's not my real home, but it's the closest thing I've had for, well... a long time. We'll just go with that.
Don't worry. I'm sure they'll come around.
I sure hope you're right.
You'll be fine. You'll be fine. Getting over the I was a bad guy hump can be awkward, but hopefully soon they'll invite you right back into their lives. Right, Jesse?
You are a strange, strange man, Ivor. But you know something? You're okay. Take care of each other, all right? And I'll see you around.
Bye, Harper.
Yes, goodbye.
Come on.
You're amazing.
So, how do we get home now?
Well, the Atlas belongs to Jesse now. The deal's a deal and all that.
So we can essentially go anywhere, I'm assuming.
Sweet.
And not just home.
How does it work?
Now you just say where you want to go, and the Atlas will show you the way. Why don't you just go ahead and open it?
Okay, Book. Take us home.
Whoa! Spectacular!
Incredible! Nice!
Okay, so it doesn't actually, like, take you home physically. It shows you which door.
Home.
I assume M told you that she's coming with?
Yeah, she's already promised to show me that awesome spin move.
It's not so great.
Figure it's about time we get heading on home, huh?
That sounds awesome.
Yeah!
Home, here we come.
Jesse, look! Can you believe it? We made it! We're home!
After four episodes.
After all that time, all those portals, we're home!
Yes, it does feel pretty good, doesn't it?
Oh, come on, was there ever any doubt? Of course we made it home.
Well, I wouldn't say I doubted you, but for a while there, I almost forgot what home even looked like.
It is good to be back.
I'm just so glad we're all back together.
That Atlas is so cool. I'm glad Otto let you keep it.
Fabulous, yes!
And that's not all we got.
Seriously? What else did you get?
Yeah, show him, Jesse.
Oh, right, the... Oh, we can use one of these. I don't really care about these two. I mean, in case we do want to actually end up going somewhere. It's either the Redstone Heart or the Atlas. Problem is, I don't want the Atlas out in the open because someone might try... Well, they can't really use the Atlas because they don't know what they're doing with it. And it only shows portals. It doesn't know how to activate it. I'm assuming. So... I mean, glowing flint and steel, that symbolizes the whole... arc, so. Problem is, I want to put all these down, honestly. Okay, the book is glitching out a little bit there, but. It sucks, the final decisions, man. Symbolize the whole arc.
The enchanted flint and steel.
The one that started the whole thing.
Yeah, none of these other adventures could have happened if it weren't for this.
And of course...
The crown of the Eversource. The magical source of all of Sky City's precious materials.
Which is now gone, but...
The mask of Cassie Rose, a.k.a. the White Pumpkin.
Oh man, that's even creepier looking than I imagined.
Palma's Redstone Heart.
I know that Palma was evil and everything, but I still kind of wish I could have seen it.
The Portal Atlas.
I could have lost all the rest so long as we got to keep that. Ha! I wonder what Sorin would have thought of it.
So much power contained within such a tiny object.
Easy there, Ivor.
Sorry.
I can't believe you got to do all those incredible things.
Makes sense, though. You were gone a long time.
Wait till we show you all the improvements we've been making to town.
Jesse?
What's up, Lucas?
So, I've been writing stuff in here, you know? And, well, it's kind of become like a legitimate book. There's just one problem. I still need to put what happened to you. You've been the hero of this whole story. It wouldn't be right to end it without saying what happened to the hero.
I'm not going with triangle. Square, no, because evil, it's not gonna be vanquished. Impossible without friends.
Just say, and he couldn't have done it without his friends.
You know something? I really like that. There, done. Well, tell the next one anyway. I was thinking that maybe we could put it in here with the other treasures. I know it's not as cool as, like, a portal atlas or a redstone heart, but it did kind of become a book about our whole adventure.
That's a great idea, Lucas. It's perfect. Hang on.
What is it?
Wasn't that where the portal atlas was a minute ago?
Ivor.
Yeah, that was definitely where you put it.
Guys, flint and steel are missing too.
Dang it, Ivor.
And where's Ivor?
He must be headed for the portal network.
Is that bad?
What should we do?
I mean, I guess he mostly knows what he's doing.
Eh, he'll be back eventually. After everything we've been through, I think I finally trust him.
Yeah?
Yeah.
To be honest, I really just don't want to bother anymore. I just want time to relax at home. Like, we've been gone for who knows how long. And that's the end of Minecraft Story Mode. I'm surprised that many people actually saved Nell. And that's almost 50-50 as well, even though it kind of doesn't really matter. But, man, it has been a good long ride. Alright, so, review of the entire game. Now, as I said in the last episode, my expectations of... Well, no, it was two episodes before. My expectations of this game wasn't exactly high because it was Minecraft Story Mode, and I was assuming, why does this exist? And so, since my brother got the game, I decided, you know what? Why not make a let's play out of it? And I can say that I have thoroughly enjoyed this game. Now, when it comes to music, music isn't exactly a big thing when it comes to Telltale games, but I can say that it's actually pretty good. And I'm actually using one of the songs for a mashup. It just, whenever that comes out, who knows. But, now, one thing I want to point out is Axel and Olivia. I feel like they were extremely underutilized because for three whole episodes, they weren't there. Like, at episode 5, they kind of just casted them away. And, like, I feel like they might have known that people didn't particularly like Axel and Olivia because, like I said before, they just threw them out. They didn't really have any major use for them, which kind of sucks. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I didn't exactly like them too much either. But at the same time, for you to not really use your characters, like, I feel like that might be the reason that they didn't use them, because people didn't like them. And it does kind of suck for that, though. And it doesn't actually make them, like, better characters because of that. Like, I understand people like Petra, Lucas, and all the other characters more, but after episode 4, they practically just disappeared until the very end. So, Now, when it comes to story, now, well, just the overall concept of this game, I love how they were able to take the concept of Minecraft, make a legitimate story off of it, which wasn't just you having to go and fight the Ender Dragon. They actually made some original story that did involve the Ender Dragon, yes, but they were able to pull some form of twist. They were able to use generally just the environment of Minecraft and make something original from that. Like, you could play this game without pretty much any form of Minecraft knowledge, and you could still thoroughly enjoy this game. And I absolutely love that. Now, I also love the fact that they used a bunch of things from, like, just common day and classic Minecraft stuff. Like, the Farlands, I actually didn't know that the Farlands were essentially, like, a glitch area for Minecraft. So, that's really cool for that to be in there. And then, for the YouTubers to have their own episode, that's really cool as well. Now, of course, this is all with this telltale fashion of particular choices between one or two. So, when it comes to me and playing games, I'm usually able to predict things very, very easily. So, whenever it came to, like, oh, like, I have to decide between one or the other at, like, some particular moment, I was able to detect that before it happened because, A, I played Telltale games before, and B, I can just normally tell these kinds of twists anyways. But, yeah, this, I can say I've thoroughly enjoyed this game. This game has made me happy. I could say that it could be better, but definitely one of the, well, with the expectations that I had, I can definitely say that they were better. Well, no, the I don't know how to explain it, actually. With the expectations that I had, I can definitely say that it came out from the end much better than how it is when I started this whole thing. I think there is a little... Okay, there is.
Well, in a very unfortunate and unexpected twist, it appears we are in the land of chickens that are indeed the size of zombies.
Which is the choice, right. The very first choice you made.
And it looks like we're just gonna have to wing it.
Unfortunately, this is actually something that I did find out because I was reading while watching someone else's playthrough, and one of the first comments I saw was about this. So, yay on that, but didn't get spoiled to anything else, which is good. But man, oh man. It also sucks that I didn't get to kill those two, but it's whatever. So, I'd like to say to you all, thank you for joining me on this journey, and our next blind journey will be Final Fantasy XV. So, until next video, till next Let's Play, till next whenever, take care.